these cell phones that might want to call you in your pocket or anything, if you like silence those right now, that would be great, so that we can enjoy really the sounds of this special moment. Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Thomas and Jennifer, to surround them with our prayers, and to share in their joy. To Jennifer and Thomas, you have been called to marriage with each other, and God has blessed you in this calling. To all those who are gathered here today, we are here to form a circle of joy and prayer in this wild and wonderful corner of creation. We arrive here at the turning of the year, in the harvest season, as the power of creation overflows in the borders and the abundance of life that is bursting forth around us, to be gathered up and savored. We come to celebrate the sweet, deep presence of abiding love. In this place, we are each and all called to be, to breathe, and to be calm. Jennifer and Thomas have invited us here to share a special moment in their lives, and together we shall bear witness to their covenant, which is made in the sight and the grace of God. They have asked that we first share a reading called Blessing of Hands. These are the hands of your partner, young and strong and full of love, holding your hands as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will hold you in grief and uncertainty. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and joy. These are the hands that will hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength. And these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Please gather yourselves now into a time of prayer. Creator, Christ, and Comforter, be with us and bless this day. Bless this couple. Bless this gathering. Be with us every step of the way, wherever our paths may take us. Remind us to call upon you as you taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Thomas and Jennifer have chosen a reading from 1 Corinthians 13. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love. Thomas, will you have this woman to be your wife? And will you love her, cherish her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, in hardship and in ease, as long as you both shall live? If you consent, please say, I do. Jennifer, will you have this man to be your husband? And will you love him, cherish him, honor and keep him, in sickness? sickness and in health, in hardship and in ease, as long as you both shall live. If you consent, please say I do and day. This is the part where we talk about how we love each other. So Jennifer and Tom met with me about a month ago and shared some things that they love about each other. And we're here to share those things with you. You all have your own stories about each of them, and you know them each in many different ways. But these are the things that they share that they love about each other. Jennifer loves that Tom is sensitive. Tom appreciates that Jennifer is funny and smart. Tom loves that Jennifer is nurturing, motherly, and always looks after his and Paige's best health and interests. Jennifer loves that besides Paige, Tom is probably the only person who considers her nurturing. Jennifer can tell that Tom loves her regardless of how she looks. He loves the woman that she is, the person that she is. He loves, she says, who I am. He loves her from the inside out. Tom shared that when they were first reconnecting after many years, although they spoke on the phone for 11 hours, he put her off because he was working on his own health and well-being. And yet, when they finally met up again, Jennifer loved him even before she saw him walk through the door. She loved him from the inside out. Tom also says that Jennifer is beautiful inside and out. Jennifer says that she and Tom connect on a whole different level that's hard to explain or to put into words. Tom agrees with the description of a deep connection and says that Jennifer is his best friend. Jennifer notes that they can simply relax together, sit by the fire, go for a ride, and talk together. Tom says that they simply want to be in each other's company and just hang out. On the day that we met to talk, they shared an example of their bond. Tom went outside and prepared a surprise in the car, so that when Jennifer checked the seat, waiting for her was a card and champagne, leaves and candles, plus he'd gotten her an extra large coffee with just enough sweetener in it. Tom says he loves to do nice things for her and he just can't stop. And again, Jennifer emphasizes how much they love to talk to each other and how they are fun together no matter what they're doing. Both of them emphasize that they have an inexplicable connection, which is hard to put into words, and yet they find strength in their capacity to communicate on a deep and meaningful level. For both Jennifer and Thomas, this is a love that has grown from the inside out. How much are you going to repeat after me? Jennifer, I take you to be my wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward, for better and for worse, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. And if I repeat after me, Thomas, I take you to be my husband, and I take you to be my husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better and for worse, for richer and for poorer, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to love and to cherish, to love and to cherish, to love and to cherish. At this time, we will exchange rings. Rings are given in token and pledge of constant faith in each other and Thomas and Jennifer's abiding love for one another. Rings are an outward and a visible sign of the inward and spiritual bond which unites your hearts in love. I ask that you all once more gather into a place of prayer with me as we bless these rings. gracious God, bless these symbols of covenant promise, that they may remind Jennifer and Thomas of your encircling love and unending faithfulness, that in their life together, they may know joy and peace in one another. Amen. Jennifer, I give this ring as a symbol of my vow, and with all that I am, and all that I have, I commit myself to you. She will be part of the blessing of their union together. Thomas and Jennifer, gathered with you are your families and friends, the loving community you have asked to be with you today. Of course, there are relationships and loves that cannot be here today, but whose connections are already woven with pain and hope into your story. These include John and Oro Mastriani, George Watson and Beverly Offen, Nani and Mimi, Olga and Bob, and Sharon. In times to come, you will encounter other significant people who will also become part of your narrative. Today, however, you are surrounded by many members of your beloved community. Their presence here is a sacred gift. I invite you to turn toward them now and receive their blessing. First, to Jennifer and Thomas's family, I ask you, as members of Thomas and Jennifer's family, will you pledge your support to this covenant that they are making today? If so, please say, "We will," or "Wait." And now to everybody, to the wide community, I ask you, as members of the beloved community that upholds Thomas and Jennifer, will you pledge your support to this covenant that they are making today? If you do, please say, "We will." Mr. and Mrs. Thomas and Jennifer Gianni.